I'd have to check my phone messages.
So you were really angry?
Oh, I was in a big huff. And then I... Oh, God. You probably don't have to worry about this. You're too young. But my, like, that hair is, like, half gray now. And it drives me crazy. And so I...
Did you buy some?
I'm thinking about it.
Oh, my God. Awesome.
But then James will... I know he will accuse me of being a hypocrite.
Oh, I bet he'll like it.
Teresa?
Well, I bet he will.
Self-conscious.
You'll get the hang of it.
You seem so... You're so good at everything.
Oh, well, I actually...
You do everything with such... You're so graceful.
Oh, wow. I... Hey, Schultz?
What?
Do you maybe want to get a cup of coffee or something after class? Or... Sorry, did I do something wrong?
No. I mean, yes. Didn't I say yes?
You didn't say anything.
Oh, God. I'm sorry. I thought I said yes. Yes!
Yeah. You're me. Can you stand up? And I'd like you to sit on the ground. Except I want you to kind of, hug your knees. Yeah. But and then kind of bury your head in. Like, yes. That looks great. Don't they look great? Wow. Okay, you can relax.
Can I go next?
Of course, yes. Everyone back at the ball. And this is just the beginning. Next week, we start reenactments.
One.
Two. Three. Four.
Five.
Six.
Seven. Start again.
My name is Theresa. I'm a very special person. I'm 35 years old. I'm very passionate about all things. I care about things very deeply. I grew up in a small town in New Hampshire. I have a younger brother named Brendan. He's getting married next summer. I lived in New York for many years. I am an actress. The decision to move to Vermont was a difficult, but I think ultimately positive one. There was a competitiveness and a claustrophobia that was very difficult for me in New York. Also, the sense that people didn't really care about each other. I've always wanted to make a difference. I have an amazing soul. Amazing warmth that people can sense the minute they meet me. I had hoped to reach people through the theater, but the realization that maybe this was impossible caused me to reevaluate and try living in a smaller place where I could work directly with people. I'm studying for a certificate in acupressure and Rolfing. About 6 months before I left New York, I broke up with my boyfriend, Mark. He was not very good to me. Sometimes I guilt myself out and try and convince myself that I ruined something and that I made a mistake, but those, my friends and people close to me, they know that I did the right thing. That was a toxic relationship. My father has prostate cancer. It's a blessing to be only a few hours away from him and to be able to see him on weekends. I'm also worried about my mother. I don't want my parents to die. Okay, yeah, that's it.
Okay, yeah. Yes, perfect. Sure. Oh, we're just trying to figure this out. Either way, why don't you start with your bed?
Will you be my bed? Sure.
What did your bed look like?
It was small, and it was next to my window.
Yeah. But can you describe some of its special qualities for James?
Small. Soft.
Okay, great. What's next? What else did you love about your childhood bedroom?
The tree outside my window.
Perfect.
Will you be the tree?
Of course. What kind of tree am I?
A maple.
Am I large or small?
Large. Oh, yeah. Will you be my baseball glove?
Can you describe some of the qualities of your baseball glove that you'd like Lauren to embody?
Oh. Yeah. Okay.
So, what else, Schultz? What else did you love about your bedroom?
My stuffed snake.
Your?
Before she died, my mother, she gave me a stuffed animal. A stuffed snake.
Would you like me to?
Yeah.
Where would you like me to go?
Will you sit on my bed?
Okay. Now take a step back and look at your bedroom. What are you feeling?
It doesn't really look like my bedroom.
But does it feel like your bedroom? Well, okay.
Sorry.
No, it's fine. Okay, we can all... Everybody can relax.
You were great.
Okay.
They're out checking the meter.
But Lauren.
I thought about you this morning. In the shower.
Oh God, we have to stop this.
We have 3 more minutes. Schultz. Come into the bathroom.
Oh, I don't think that's a good idea.
Just for a minute. Just for a minute.
Are you getting excited about school starting in a few weeks?
Not sure.
That's understandable. I guess school is a bit of a mixed bag.
She won't pick up. Her phone is on, but she just won't pick up.
Do you want me to call her?
No, that's absurd. She's so fucking ungrateful.
Well, I don't think I would agree with that assessment.
Okay, could you please... Sorry? You're smiling like something hilarious just happened.
Oh, no. Sorry.
Goulash. Akmak.
Goulash, goulash, goulash. Goulash, goulash, goulash. Goulash, goulash, goulash. Goulash, goulash, goulash.
Akmak. 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 Akmak.
Goulash.
Akmak.
Goulash, 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 goulash.
Akmak. Akmak, akmak, akmak.
Goulash, goulash.
Akmak, akmak.
Okay. Good. Stop. What were they communicating?
They seemed very connected.
Uh-huh. Good. They were in love. But what was actually happening, though? Like, what was being said? Sorry, said. What was being said?
Well, the sentiment was...
At first she seemed upset.
It seemed like she was sharing a secret.
Yeah.
But I thought that... It felt like James... understood her.
I'm sorry. Excuse me.
Should someone...
I will.
No. It's okay. I'll be right back.
Look.